Top 30 Doctor Who stories ever. 10 to 1. 10. The Riboz Operation. The first story of season 16, The Key to Time season, makes it into my top 10. Wildly underrated by a fandom whose appreciation for great writing over bangs and flashes has never been particularly evident, The Riboz Operation is yet another story in this list to come from the pen of the peerless Robert Holmes. Essentially a character-based comedy drama about a gigantic confidence trick being played on a deposed dictator, The Riboz Operation is its atmosphere, humor and pathos, and features some of the richest characters ever seen in the series brought to life by some wonderful actors. Mary Tam makes a fantastic debut as Romana, with her bickering relationship with Tom's doctor a comedic highlight of this wonderful tale. 9. Horror of Fang Rock. The Williams era strikes again with this atmospheric horror story set in an isolated island lighthouse in the Edwardian age. Former script editor and all-round Who legend Terence Dix provides the first of no less than three stories in my all-time top 10 from his pen, with the Tom Baker and Louise Jameson partnership at its peak. Fang Rock is a period horror masterwork. 8. City of Death. I gave this much-loved story somewhat short shrift in my season 17 overview, and I really need to redress that with a proper full-length review at some point, because if any story deserves one, it's this. The best story of the magnificent season 17 and the even more magnificent Graham Williams era. Doctor Who has never been funnier, Lala Ward has never been sexier, Tom Baker has never been muddier, and Julian Glover makes a better James Bond villain here than he actually did when he did it for real in For Your Eyes Only. With Paris location shooting and a witty, imaginative, magical script from Douglas Adams on peak form, City of Death is one of the best stories ever. 7. The Invasion. The only Cybermen story in my top 20 is not just one of the very best stories of the Patrick Troughton era, but one of the finest ever made. The Invasion runs for no less than 8 amazing episodes and yet never drags or sags or disappoints for a moment. Nicholas Courtney is back for his second appearance, with dear old Alistair now officially the Brigadier, and with Zoe on gorgeous, whip-smart form. Kevin Stoney as one of the greatest Who villains of all time. Extensive location shooting and action scenes and the Cybermen at their most impressive. Together with the very impressive animation of the missing two episodes, The Invasion is a season 7 story a year earlier, and even better than most of those still great stories to boot. 6. Survival. The final story of the classic series and the end of one of my favorite if far too short periods of the show, The McCoy Era, Survival is an amazing science fiction fantasy story with Anthony Ainley, Sylvester McCoy and Sophie Aldred at their best, a magnificent script, and superb direction and music. Survival again shows up the absurd lie that there was anything wrong with 80s Who. You know, now that I mention it, I think there might just be a video in that somewhere. 5. The Deadly Assassin. That man Robert Holmes is back again, reinventing the Master and the Time Lords and showing us Gallifreyan society for the very first time in what is also the very first story in the history of the program to have the Doctor sans companion. And he does it all so fucking effortlessly, making such astonishingly beautiful writing seem so bloody easy. It isn't, of course, but then that was the genius of the man. The Deadly Assassin is riveting, fascinating, magical and thrilling, and Peter Pratt is one of the finest and most criminally underrated masters ever. 4. State of Decay. This vampire horror tale from Tom Baker's last season is another 80s classic, shove that in your cake holes 80s bashers. It's effectively the only gothic horror story featuring my all-time favorite TARDIS crew, Tom, Lala and K-9, and shows up again how wonderful they are no matter what kind of story you put them in. Terence Dix again gives us another fantastic story, and it almost pisses me off beyond measure how fucking underrated this is by fandom. If it had the name Philip Hinchcliffe at the end of it, these fuckers would be all over it, let's face it. The best story of season 18 by several thousand country fucking miles. 3. Spearhead from Space. John Pertwee's debut story, and the arrival of the 1970s and color to Doctor Who, Spearhead is an incredibly iconic tale from, guess whom, Mr. Robert fucking Holmes yet again. This was one of the first Pertwee's and indeed pre-McCoy stories I saw back in the day as a young fan, and time and many, many rewatches have not dimmed its luster, remaining one of my favorite ever slices of televisual comfort food. 2. The War Games. Mr. Dix is back again, this time in collaboration with Malcolm Hulk, to write a 10-part serial that is one of the most amazing, haunting, magical, gripping and ripping adventure stories of all time. It's the swan song for Mr. Patrick Troughton, together with Jamie and sexy little Zoe, and no Doctor or TARDIS team has ever been given a more incredible send-off. An epic story in every sense of the word, and one that changes the character and the series forever. The War Games was once underrated but seems to have finally gotten the kudos it all deserved of late, being voted the best story of the 60s in the 2013 DWM poll. Though even that is probably still underrating it. 1. The Talons of Weng-Chiang. In truth, this magnificent six-part slice of gothic comedy horror from the marvelously imaginative Robert Holmes is probably tied at the number one spot with War Games, but I tend to give it the top spot nowadays because it pisses off the PC cunts, which just makes me love it all the more. Talons is another stunning showcase for Bob Holmes' impeccable scripting skills, and with some of the finest direction, production values and acting ever seen in the series, it richly deserves its kudos from fandom and from yours truly. This is the kind of story that just makes you want to hug yourself in glee. So there you have it, folks. My all-time top 30, and my all-time top 10. Of course, the running order will probably change by next year, but that's just the way these things work. One thing that won't change is how much I adore these stories, these actors and this show. Feel free to list your top 10 below.